The question asked by Himanshu is, how can others judge whether ego dominates me? How can others judge? It's not important, Himanshu, at all. It's not important at all to worry about what others are judging. To be obsessed with others, that itself is ego. So, those of you who are sharp enough will see that this question itself is ego. Whenever you are too bothered about how others are looking at you, that itself is ego. What is the ego? Ego means I do not know myself, and my sense of self, my self-concept, my self-image comes from the opinions of others. To be bothered with what others think of me is a sure shot indicator of ego. Are you getting this? Are you with me? Are you understanding this?
Yes, sir.
What else is ego? Except this obsession, except this botheration, that what is he thinking of me? And if he is thinking bad of me, then oh my God. What is she thinking of me? I hope she thinks highly of me. This concern itself is ego, because ego is nothing but this. I do not know myself. I think I am what you think I am. You think I am brilliant, then I start believing that I am brilliant. You tell me that I am worthless, then I start believing that I am worthless. This dependence on others' opinions, this internalization of what others have to give, itself is ego. Are you getting it? I do not know myself. All I know of myself is in terms of what others have given me. Others have given me a religion, so I think I am a Hindu. Others have given me a belief system, so I think that this is the way one should live his life. Others have given me a few certificates, and I think that that's what I am. Others have given me a lot of identities, and I think that's what I am. This perpetual obsession with the other itself is ego, Himanshu. Why should you bother what others think of you? A far more valuable question is, how am I really? If you are sick, deeply sick, but others think that you are healthy, will your life become joyful? Will your life become joyful? Yes. So why should you ask, sir, do the others think I am healthy? Or should your question be, sir, am I healthy? Really? What is the more valuable question? Am I really healthy? But no, you are not asking that. Your question still is, sir, how are the others judging me? And if you are really healthy, but others keep on telling you that you are sick, that would only prove that the others are mad. Am I right? The real concern must be, Manishu, to find out how I really am. Not how others judge me. How I really am, that's a good question to ask. That's a very, very good question to ask. What really is the quality of my mind? What keeps on going around here? That's a really good question to ask. But ask whom? Not some other person. ask yourself, because it is your life, and what you do from morning till evening, every day, itself is the book where the answer is available. You want to find out what is the quality of your life? Observe yourself on any particular day. Do you find that you are often bored, confused, frustrated? Do you find that you come to the college feeling a little heavy? Do you find that you feel like studying only when the exams arrive? Do you find that you often require an external motivation to proceed in life? And all this can be observed on a day-to-day basis. Figure that out and then you will see how you really are. Don't ask others. When you enter a classroom, where do you prefer sitting? At the back or at the front? Watch it. And if you prefer sitting at the back, what does that tell you? Are you really enjoying your studies? Are you really enjoying your studies? Do you often need entertainment? Because a thirst for entertainment is an indication of boredom. And boredom means I'm not present here. I do not like it. I'm not immersed in what is happening. Watch your day-to-day activities. They themselves will reveal to you how you really are. Forget about how others will judge you and whether others can judge you. Don't depend on their judgment. Don't be bothered with all that. Observe your life using your own eyes. Is that clear? Observe your life using your own eyes. When am I silent? Am I silent only when there is an external pressure and the mind still keeps on wandering and gossiping? And the moment I get a slight chance to create mischief, like when there was this short interruption in the power supply, I start doing something, that only means that I have been suppressed. And the moment I get a chance, all that which has been suppressed, that comes out. Don't you see that? It's visible in all your actions. It's visible in all your thoughts. You just need to observe your actions and thoughts. And then you will know how you really are, without the help of any external person, any external agency or book. That will be really useful. That will be really useful. Yes, Manjit?